Growing up as a refugee in South Africa, it was not easy. My father really struggled a lot to get work, to feed me. There was a few times when like we came close to sleeping on the street. When I was 6 years old, my father couldn't afford for me to continue going to school because he did not have the 50 rand a month, which is maybe an equivalent of 5 euros or something like that. I was born in Congo, DRC. We left Congo when I was 4 years old because of the civil war there and the unrest. It was not safe for our family to be in Congo. One of the only memories I have of Congo was just as a young girl. I remember a group of people that seemed like an army came into where we were living with guns and they just held everyone up. That's literally the only image that I have of Congo, of that, the unsafeness that it felt and so scared. In South Africa, whenever the league started, I would not be able to start the league with everyone else because my refugee papers were not seen as legitimate papers. So I would always have to wait like sometimes 1 month, sometimes 2 months, sometimes 3 months until when I can join my teammates and play, all because I had refugee papers. So I just carried on training, carried on showing up at training until when they said she can play now. When I was young, my closest dream was just to get to university because I knew that having an education will help me to have a better future. Football was only a tool that I was using to get my education. It felt extremely special, especially when I was in South Africa and when the news broke out and every single South African news outlet, every single radio wanted to interview me about it. That's when it hit me that, oh wait, this is actually really huge. That's when I realized that this is something extremely special and I treasure the moment and I appreciate the experience. No matter where I am, if I hear of them being treated bad, my heart breaks because, you know, because that's who I was. When I hear of them not being given equal opportunities, my heart breaks because, you know, that's who I was. So, yeah, and when I hear countries closing their borders to them, my heart breaks because that could have been me. I could have been stuck in the Congo, maybe killed. Because a country closed their doors to me, so yes, yeah, it has made me more sympathetic, made my heart, you know, I'm always for refugees, and I think I always will be. That would be a great achievement to be able to say, once my football is done, that I've played in a major tournament. It's something to be proud of, and it's something that people can look up to, young girls can look up to, and when young girls can say that, hey, that girl, if that girl could do it, so can I.